More U.S. citizens have arrived in Florida after waiting weeks to evacuate Haiti, which descended into chaos earlier this month. Now, this comes as armed gangs launched a new round of attacks near the capital city of Port-au-Prince yesterday. As the U.S. State Department is working on efforts to get the remaining Americans out of the country, some Democrats are demanding that the Congress send in more aid. For more on this, let's bring in Democratic New York Congresswoman Yvette Clarke. She is one of the co-chairs of the Haiti Caucus. Congresswoman, thanks so much for joining us.
It's my pleasure to be with you this morning. Unfortunately, under these circumstances.
Terrible and tragic circumstances. So let me ask you, what actions is the caucus calling on with regards to President Biden to do in Haiti?
Well, President Biden has requested that the Congress act to provide the funding that is required to bring in a multilateral force to help bring safety, security to Haiti. And we are in the process now of appealing to both the Speaker of the House, Mike Johnson, and the Chairman of the Foreign Affairs Committee, Michael McCaul, to authorize that funding. And it's, you know, a situation where the nation is descending into anarchy, and we really need to bring some stability to the nation.
The commander of the U.S. Southern Command said that they're prepared to send military forces into Haiti. If the president wants to see that happen, do you think it's something that the U.S. should do? Do you think it's something that would make a difference?
Now, I think that it's important that we bring as many partners to the region as possible. I don't know that a unilateral security force coming out of the United States into Haiti is the best approach to bringing stability. We've had a number of meetings at the UN where a number of nations have stood up, CARICOM region nations, as well as some of the continental African forces that are prepared in this moment to go in and to help to bring the national police the support that they need to bring civility back to the nation.
So, Congresswoman, as you know, Republicans are blocking $40 million in aid to help stabilize Haiti. And one of their concerns is that the aid could fall into the hands of gangs there. And to be fair to the Republicans, your friends on the other side of the aisle, they're not perhaps wrong about that. We've seen over and over over the course of Haiti's recent history that money raised for Haiti to help the people of Haiti oftentimes does not actually get into their hands. And that is across the board from organizations like the Red Cross, who failed miserably in the wake of the 2010 earthquake to do what they said they were going to do. Millions of Americans opened up their wallets and pocketbooks to help provide that aid. And we see the situation that Haiti is in today. Nothing has really changed, even before these gangs started to run amok. So how do you give assurances that that money will get to those in need?
Absolutely. Well, there has to be accountability. There's no doubt about that. What we're talking about is working with the UN, working with other trusted sources to make sure that the funding, the arms that need to go to bring the stability to the nation is accounted for. And I think those mechanisms have already been set up based on the conversations that we have had with our State Department to make that happen. No one wants these arms or the funding to fall into the hands of the gangs. And so I think that I know that we are in a position to bake in the accountability that is required to make sure that, again, that that's not the case and that we move expeditiously to bring some stability to the nation.
As you know, Kenya was supposed to be sending a police force to Haiti. They've sort of put that on pause, and there was a little bit of pushback with some Kenyans wondering, why are we sending police? We don't share a border with Haiti. Are we simply doing it because we're going to receive money? Is that enough of a reason to go there? I want you to talk to us about the challenges when it comes to finding countries willing to offer up troops or police to really put boots on the ground to help to stabilize the situation there. What are you hearing about the concerns?
Yeah, I think that they're valid concerns. We need to make sure that those who have stepped up to partner with us, have the backing of their civil societies to do so. And it was our understanding that those conversations have been held at Kenya's legislature, that there have been a number of conversations, particularly with the CARICOM nations, the nations of the Caribbean, to partner with Kenya, as well as other stakeholders globally who have a commitment to the people of Haiti. And want to see the nation stabilized, and that the safety and security of the people of Haiti is paramount in this moment.
So, Congresswoman, you mentioned CARICOM, which, to our viewers who may not be familiar, CARICOM is the Caribbean Community. It's an intergovernmental agency that was established in the early 1970s. The member states include most of the countries in the Caribbean, ranging from Jamaica to Dominica to Trinidad and Tobago, Belize, Barbados, all those countries that are in that part of the world. But I wonder what you can brief us on, and if you've been briefed, members of Congress have been briefed on some of the discussions that are happening there as it relates to Haiti's future. We know that the Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, has been part of those talks. We know the former U.S. ambassador to South Africa, Patrick Gaspard, has also been involved in those talks. What are they telling you about what they plan on announcing in the days ahead?
Well, absolutely. They have been engaged from day one because, like the United States, they're neighboring states to Haiti, and clearly see them as part of their CARICOM community. And, their hearts are bleeding over the dissension of this nation into a chaotic situation and what the impact will be for their small states, as well as, the potential for migration that comes from, the level of distress that the people of Haiti are under. What I'm hearing is that they've had a number of conversations with the current president of Haiti, who's an interim president, and they've expressed to him that it's important to get a presidential transitional council in place so that the nation can move forward to bring democracy back. That there's governance structure in place, and that Haiti can move forward with all of the institutions working to address the myriad of issues that the Haitian people are facing in this moment, from starvation to lawlessness. All of that needs to be addressed, and that needs to be done through the instruments of government that need to be stood up by Haitian people for Haitian people.
All right. Congresswoman Yvette Clarke, thank you so much.
Thank you.